From the End Groove Remains production team studios in the Netherlands, my name is Mix Master G and welcome to this totally unscheduled live stream. My mission is not to sell you as many apps as I can. No, my mission is to educate and teach you about collection management and conversion for DJs so you save yourself more time for the fun and creative part of being a DJ. First, some household things. All of a sudden, my neighbor started to chainsaw a tree. So if you think, what am I hearing? It's not Halloween yet around the ATGR studios. It's a real chainsaw and there is a real tree being chained there. So, or sold there. So just that you know. Another thing, Yvette is at a regular job now, which means I have my eyes on the chat halfway, but will not react to it immediately. If I see some spamming going on in the chat, I will block that user and then I will dive into any questions you may have or may not have at the moment I see them appearing. That all being said, this is going to be a special stream and it was totally unscheduled. How does it come? Last Tuesday, I showed you how you use Rekordbox 6 in the cloud. And in the cloud also means with Dropbox, etc. And while I was doing that stream, I was thinking, hey, didn't Denon Prime and Engine Prime and Engine OS, I hate that term, have a Dropbox functionality as well? And indeed, they do have that. It is currently in beta and you need to have Engine Prime 1.6 for that. And your Prime gear needs to be on Engine OS 1.6. But if you have that, then there is Dropbox functionality there. Now, mind you, this is beta software, which means some things don't work right, some things are bugged, etc. I already contacted my contacts at Denon DJ to provide them with some feedback because there are some odd things going on inside it. But what I did is I just, as always, worked around it. I circumvented those odd things, which means we have a workable solution to go from a Rekordbox collection, and that can be a Rekordbox 6 or a Rekordbox 5 collection, whatever you want, a Traktor collection, a Serato collection, a Virtual DJ collection, to Dropbox. And the next thing you do when you have it on Dropbox is you go to your Prime gear, you log into your Dropbox account, and all your tracks are there with the cues, with the loops, with everything there. So this is powerful stuff. I'll go by it step by step. First of all, you need to have, of course, obviously, a Dropbox account. Now, there are a gazillion ways to set Dropbox up. For my tools and for Denon Prime, by the way, to work, Dropbox requires to be on the root of your home folder, like there, and not in a different storage location, not on an external drive, not somewhere hidden in documents, etc. This is the default Dropbox location, and it needs to be in that default location. You can change the default Dropbox location right here in the Dropbox thingy. And there you can say that it needs a different location and stuff like that. But don't do that. Don't do that. Just leave everything as it is by default, and that means your Dropbox location is at the root of your home folder. So if you press the home button like this, that's the little home button, then it's with desktop documents, etc. in that neighborhood. Very important. Another important thing is the Denon Conversion Utility assumes you are using Engine Prime 1.6 or higher. And the beta, which you can download from the Denon DJ forum, is indeed version 1.6. However, that is called the Engine Prime Beta, as you see right here. And you don't want that. It needs to be Engine Prime because that is what the DJ Conversion Utility checks on. Easy to fix that. Just call this one 1.5.1 because that's the version it is. You can see that right here, that indeed it's version 1.5.1. And then rename the beta into Engine Prime by taking the beta and the space off, like this. And then you have a working Engine Prime Beta. If you don't do this, then the Denon Conversion Utility will throw warnings at you because stuff can go wrong. That doesn't mean that things can get broken, but it just won't function the way you want it to function. So that's why that is there. I'm going to start off with Rekordbox, and as always, I'm on Rekordbox 5.6 because that's my favorite Rekordbox version. But what I'm about to show you works the same on Rekordbox 6 if you use 6.2x, my Rekordbox 6 XML export tool, which comes free with the DJ Conversion Utility, with the Denon Conversion Utility, and most other tools that use Rekordbox, so you can use it. Or you can do this straight from a tractor collection converted by DGCU to a Rekordbox XML, a Serato collection to convert to XML. That all works the same, folks. I just use Rekordbox 5.6 because it's snappy and I can immediately show you what we are doing. Let's take the Billie Holiday track as our reference track, and let's give that track a memory queue, which is not possible with Engine Prime because it doesn't convert memory queues. And let's give it a hot loop, which is also not possible because it doesn't use the hot loops. But Denon has promised me that they are finally going to fix that. So maybe in the future these things are not a problem anymore. You can see we have two different playlists there. These tracks are stored on my file server named Terabyte, which means they are totally incompatible with Engine Prime because Engine Prime cannot read from a file server. And these are local files just being on my desktop and just two mashups I made. Nothing serious, but two different files representing either tracks that are stored on your startup drive or tracks that are stored on your external drive. Talking about that, keep in mind that Dropbox in general duplicates tracks on your startup drive. So when I'm going to push a track into Dropbox, that actually means that I'm going to copy that track or move that track, a copy of it, to this folder, which is on my startup drive. So you need to have sufficient room on your startup drive to store duplicates of tracks. If your tracks are also stored on your startup drive by default, if you use Dropbox. Therefore, I find this solution best as kind of an emergency solution. So I just want to have my tracks available to me whenever I want. And I find it less appropriate for complete collections because then you basically are going to ask a lot from your startup drive in terms of storage capacity. And this will also be a thing if you go to other users and use your Dropbox drive. More about that later. So we have, where's my Rekordbox collection? Oh, I did quit it. We have the Rekordbox collection, that's fine. And we export it to an XML. And if we name it Rekordbox, like that. And we store it in its default location, then my tools automatically can find it. We fire up the collection backup tool, and mind you, this is a new version of the collection backup tool. It's a beta, and everyone who has an official license for the Denon Conversion Utility can ask me to join the beta team. It has been properly tested, but there are some things Denon is going to change most likely in the near future about the beta software, and that's why I'm calling it beta, and I think make it final when the firmware for Dropbox on the player and Engine Prime are finally final. Right now you will see that you have the option to select a Dropbox drive. And that is brand new because you didn't have that option before. And that's what you want to do. You see right here that it automatically found the Rekordbox XML I just exported. And right here you can see that it will automatically start the Denon Conversion Utility. Basically, I'm fully good to go. I just hit start backup, and let me open the Dropbox drive so you can see what's going on there. I don't want to ask again. Always, if you got that thing, just delete everywhere, because that makes sure that everything is in sync. Utility needs your attention. That is the famous robot for stage, which means we are already at the Denon Conversion Utility. We go to the Analyze these first grade, select all the tracks, analyze them. Quit Engine Prime. I cannot pre-quit Engine Prime anymore. Denon, I want that feature back with the little pull-down menu, quit Engine Prime when done, and not this dialogue and having to click yes, because then I cannot run it overnight. So Denon, please bring that back. That was very, very useful. Thank you. Do I want to see the log? No, I don't want to see the log. And then we had the Billie Holiday track. If we load it up, then we've got the beat marker there, the memory cue I set there, and the hot loop right there. So you see everything is right there as we set it in record box. Now here you think, so what? I tell you what, because if we are going to walk to our Prime player, and for me that is a Prime SC5000, running the 1.6 beta software, because otherwise you don't have the Dropbox functionality, great things are going to happen. But first of all, you see that little sync thingy there in the Dropbox upper hand corner. That means Dropbox is still busy. So I cannot go to the Prime player yet, because Dropbox needs to sync to the cloud. And because we have a stream running and the stream rate is dropping rapidly, I can tell, I can see that. That means we have to wait for it to finish, and hopefully then the stream will be back up to speed. Let me take a look. We have, I've been looking at this feature this morning and it looks great. Should we be viewing your screen? Oh, damn, I forgot to switch my screen. Oh, that's my bad. That happens all the time. Thank you, SD Powell, for pointing that out. You know what? I'm going to reset this. I'm going to start all over again, because I was forgetting, my bad, to switch to the screen. So usually you can see the screen. Right now you cannot see the screen. So please bear with me. Let me reset everything we did. Let me take that off like this. And then let's do this. There you have my screen, as you can see. And then I just deleted everything from the Dropbox file. I just take it from the top, folks, because what I told you is important. So let me change that back to the situation you normally have. And then, sorry for that, folks, but shit like that happens. So starting over from the top of where we are. Engine Prime, you need to make sure that the beta is called Engine Prime, because right now, as you can see here, this is Engine Prime. Oh, it won't give me the version anymore. I don't know why, but maybe it finds that it was a little bit too often changed. But what you do is, this is 1.5.1, so you rename that to 1.5.1, and then you rename the Engine Prime beta into Engine Prime by cutting off the beta part. So that is basically it. That is important, because the Denon Conversion Utility will look for that if it is there. Then the next part was, I went to Recordbox. And in Recordbox, I had and still have two playlists, as you can see here. One with tracks stored on the terabyte. That is my file server, which Engine Prime does not support, so it doesn't work with that file server. And I did put a memory queue right there, and I saw that it was a little bit out of whack, so let me put it right on the beat there. While I'm at it, why not? And just put it at it again. I think my quantize might be on, but oh no, it's off. Oh, that should be good then. Take that one away. That one there, queue it up, put it into memory, and let's call it memq, so we know what we are looking about. And I put in a hot loop which didn't have a proper length. As you can see, it doesn't make much sense, but it's just a hot loop just for demonstration purposes only. I export this stuff to XML and we name it record box. Record box with a B. And it overrides the existing one. That's all there is to it. There's nothing more that we need to do. After that, we start up the collection backup tool. And let me open my Dropbox folder so you can see that is entirely empty. There is nothing going on there. And as you can see at the top of my screen, oh, you can see that right now. But now you can. Right here, you see that Dropbox is idle. Nothing is happening with Dropbox because otherwise you would see that little synchronization thingy. I put this one to the side so you can see what is going on. And we say we want to go from a Recordbox XML. That is automatically the one I just exported. That's automatically recognized by the collection backup tool. All I need to do, tell it, is that we go to Dropbox. Again, you need to have that Dropbox folder straight under your home folder. So if you click on the home button symbol, then Dropbox should be right there with the green thingy behind it for me. Any other location will not work. So please have it there, otherwise you are in trouble. We are going to start this up. And I see some questions or some comments in the chat, so I will go through that in a minute because I have to wait for Dropbox to finish synchronizing anyway if this is all done. So
the Denon Conversion Utility needs your attention.
Then we have all the time. This is basic Denon Conversion Utility stuff that was automatically initiated by the collection backup tool. Everything is basically on automatic, folks. You don't see me doing anything. We open the analyses first folder. Let me take that one away. Let me put that one off so we have a little bit of a clean overview. We select all the tracks in the analyze these first folder. These are analyzed. I quit Engine Prime and now I have to click yes. Denon, please fix that. We used to have a nice pull down menu there that I could say quit when Engine Prime is done, which was very helpful if you had a long analyzation or an analysis running overnight. Then you could just put it on automatic, but that's no longer possible, so sorry for that. Then we go to the Billie Holiday track, and you can see the memory queue has indeed become a queue. This is the most significant beat mark. You saw that the grid was off in Recordbox, so that's perfectly fine. And this is the hot loop. Both would be impossible to convert using standard Engine Prime, but Denon promised me that they are going to fix that. Now the fun part begins. It looks like it is already done with synchronizing because you can see, oh no, it's still burning. No, it's done. Okay, then we're good to go. Then we walk over to the SE5000, and I got a camera for that. Oh yes, we got a camera for that. And then things get a little bit tricky. First of all, you still need to have a drive connected to it. It can be an empty drive, but there needs to be a drive connected to your Prime gear for this to work. I have already asked Denon not to do that. I'm going to in details why not later on. First, let me show you how this works. We press the View Utilities button. You come in the Utilities. You can go to the Dropbox part. Hold on, I'm in the wrong one because I was looking if I could dim my screen and it didn't give me that option. So, and you see that there is a code there and I need to go to enginedj.com Dropbox auth. Now, let's do that. Let's fire up. I think my Chrome has my password saved. I hope so. Otherwise, I have to copy and paste them. But this is a demo account anyway, so I'm not really very worried about it. What was the site again? EngineDJ.com. EngineDJ.com and then /. And then Dropbox auth. like that. All right, let's do this. Yay, we are going to do this. And then indeed it asks for my credentials, which I did put in a little note for myself. And you are free to see it, because like I told you, this is just a test account, so no harm can come from it. And it's always fun if you're doing Denon thingy, save it. All right, now I need that code that is showed on the player, and that was BNGUA, all right. And if we pair that up and we go back to the player, then in a moment it will tell us, yay, we are true, your Dropbox library is ready to use. And if we go to the Denon Conversion Utility and we go to the terabyte files and we find that Billie Holiday track and we load it up and it's loading it right there, then yay, we got right there the memory queue, we got the beat marker, and we got the hot loops there. So as you can see, everything is there converted as we expected it to be. Though I'm not completely happy about the placement. Oh no, that's fine. It's there. All right. So as you can see, everything is there as it should be. And that's the fun part of this. You can just do it straight from it. Now I'm going to show you some things which I don't like about this. First of all, if I want to disconnect from Dropbox, I have to put away my drive. And I take my drive with me. And I'm going to connect it to my computer. So you can see what's on that drive actually. This can go. Let me show you all. And this can go and that can go for now. And where is my putz drive? That is right here. Let's hook it up. Of course, we use the wrong cable. All right, there we are. There's my putz drive. Now, if you look inside the engine library folder, there's a cloud folder there, there's a Dropbox folder there. That's the stuff that wasn't there before, I can tell you. But my problem with it is that it stores the tracks I have loaded. So we have loaded, you see some other stuff which was there from previous testing. It should be right here in the startup drive, I guess. No, that's not what I'm looking for. Kind of a mess there, isn't it? Oh, you see this one, Billie Holiday, that's the one we just took a look at and I just loaded, which means if I'm a big name producer and I'm on a festival stage and I have Prime gear and I log into my Dropbox account and I'm going to play all my exclusive in a set, all those exclusives are stored on the drive that is inside the SE6000 or inside the SE6000M or whatever. You don't want that, Denon, so don't cache to the drive. Just cache in memory, cache what is necessary in just a temporary folder, but don't cache the whole kaboom on that drive, because I don't want my tracks spread around on every Prime gear and Prime drive I have played on, just because you forget to clean up the mess after you sign out. So please, please, please take that away. We don't want that. Then I'm going to first look at what is going on in the chat. So give me a moment for that. Mac Joseph has a bug with the Prime 4. Well, you can see, Mac, it is working perfectly with mine, so that can be a real problem there. Both for the user, my beta does a beach ball every time. JC lost me. Thank you, Jake. No, sorry, I'm not going to Australia, especially not with the current situation, but thank you for the kind words. Okay, folks, so this was part one. Now I'm going to tell you what I don't like about this. There is a serious bug, and let me show you what's happening there. Usually, everything the collection backup tool and all the other tools do are restricted to this little folder, the Dropbox track backup tool folder. Why that name? That name is there because in the past it was called Dropbox track backup tool, and then I added iTunes, and then it was no longer covering what it does, so I had to change it, and that's why it's still there. It's legacy. But the tracks used to be there too. Due to a bug on the firmware, and again, this is beta firmware, and I really hope that Denon is going to fix this. Tracks need to be stored in the music folder within the engine library. So if you look there, there you find the Dropbox track backup tool, and there you find things as they usually would be. You see that? But that is not the place I want them to be. Because if you are a Dropbox 6 user and you use the cloud sync with Dropbox, that means you have duplicate tracks on your Dropbox folder. There would be one track outside the engine library used by Dropbox, and then there would be a track inside the engine library because otherwise the firmware can't load it. The bug I saw doesn't is not a problem in Engine Prime. In Engine Prime, everything works flawless, but it is really a bug inside Dropbox. And let me show you that even more. Why not? I can show you that right now. Let's make here a little test folder here. Open it up. Put a random track in it. There we've got a rather copy it so I keep. I rather copy it because then I keep my demo tracks in order, and otherwise I run out of demo tracks. So I've got a file that is not in the engine library folder. It's still on Dropbox. Let me show that we know exactly what we are talking about. Let me fire up Engine Prime. And let's have a sip. And don't worry, folks, I hear. Why is Engine Prime not starting? Come on. Because it can be found. All right, then we do it manually. There are some other tricks we are going to do with this Dropbox folder, because it's not only usable for Engine Prime, it's usable for everything, for Tractor, for Serato, for Dropbox even. So there is more use to this than what I'm showing you now, but this is brand new for Prime, so I thought, well, let's start with it. And the fact that you can log in on your Prime gear, on your player, and have everything at your fingertips is so powerful and so smart. So that's why I'm doing it this way. And then we are going to look at the other possibilities. Let's create a new crate, and let's call this crate This Goes Wrong. And in that crate, we put the Ministry of Funk track like this. And you see it's analyzing, that's fine. And you can see it is loading, that's fine. But here's the problem. If I quit Engine Prime, you see in Engine Prime everything is hunky-dory, fine, nothing, no problems. Let's wait for the sync to finish. Sync is finished. Always do that, folks. And by the way, don't forget to log out your player before you start working in Engine Prime. Otherwise, you will overwrite the stuff you just did with the stuff from the player. I just had that happening to myself. So that's why I'm very special about it. Don't do that. Be logged out on the player. Make sure you are not connected to Dropbox on the player or anywhere else. And just on your engine computer, be connected to Dropbox. Just another warning. That has been done. What did I? Oh yeah, I wanted to go to the player again to show you. And I need my Prutz drive back. Let me empty the Prutz drive. Let me show that to you too. So this is totally fully open kimono. Open kimono, as you can see. Empty the trash, that there are no trickery going on. Prutz drive is entirely empty. And we walk up. You see, I learned quickly, don't I? I know when to switch screens and when to switch cams, but hey, I'm doing this as a one-man band, so give me some slack, please. All right, here we are, we connect to the pruts. If you don't connect to a drive, you can still log into Dropbox. However, then it will tell you you need the drive and you need to jump through all the hoops again. I already talked about Denon, talked to Denon about this, and that I really don't like that. I either don't want to be able to log into Dropbox, or I want to log into Dropbox and have no problems with it. So that's an easy thing to fix, and I hope they will do that. They don't have to listen to me, of course, because I'm just a guy, but I think I have some clever ideas sometimes. Logged into Dropbox, and I need to pair it again. That's another thing on my mind. Why do I need to pair it each time? Since it requires a computer or a drive, it can store that. I didn't want to have that one. I needed Google. And then let's hope that the history is still in effect. Yeah, that's expired, I thought so. No problem. But I'm really lazy, so maybe I should make a bookmark out of this, because I can imagine that I'm going to use this more often. Maybe I do that some other time. Let's do it! I don't think it has remembered my credentials. That's nice. Sometimes things work as you want, and then things are beautiful. I need my code, that is NNSSO. All done. And we go back to there. And my Dropbox is ready to use. And we go to the grades. And we go to the disk goes wrong. And you can see that track is right there. Like nothing is wrong, the track is there. Now let's try to load it. There you go, fail to load. That is because it is outside the engine library music folder. Again, I'm talking with Denon about this because this can be a huge problem and causing big duplicates, which you really don't want. Next up, why not? Next up is a quick check of what is going on in the chat. Jay, glad you liked the CDJ 3000 streams with my buddy Jeroen Groenendijk from Pioneer DJ. Yeah, we Jeroen and I are both geeks and we have the same DJ heart. We have the same passion for all things DJ. So if we are together, things might look like we are in a fight and in a quarrel, but we really appreciate each other, know each other, and respect each other. But we want to make our points, and we are good at that. So those things are fun to watch. But if we call each other up, we better have 3-4 hours time, because we never have a short conversation ever in our lives. I know the guy for like 5 years now. We never had a short conversation. It always takes a very long time if we are together. All right, next up. This, of course, also works with iTunes. Yay, iTunes. And I hope I did prepare something. Yay, I did prepare something. We have a little iTunes collection right there. Oh, yay, Midnight at Oasis by the Brand New Heavies. One of my favorites. I'm that old soul guy and jazz guy and house guy. So that's one of the tracks I really, really dig. But we are not here to dig tracks. We started the collection backup tool. And we tell it that we want to go to Dropbox. We tell it that we this time around use an iTunes XML. And mind you, folks, that I'm right here on a Mojave machine, so I don't need to export my collection to XML. That's all done by iTunes for me. One of the reasons why I'm on a Mojave machine and not on a Catalina machine. No automatic Denon Conversion Utility integration for that, but that's fine. Just let it roll. Have a sip. And then we fire up the Denon Conversion Utility after it's done. And you can see that Dropbox is syncing, but we don't mind. And again, the stream might stutter if Dropbox is syncing. I see that on the speed. So you know why that is happening. Automatically was selected, and that's important to notice, the Dropbox iTunes Music Library, because that is what I want to use indeed. And that's automatically selected, so Denon Conversion Utility is all set to go. You just press Start Conversion. Basic. This is all basic Denon Conversion Utility stuff, but internally I had to do a shitload of stuff to make this possible, folks. Trust me, this is not a very simple exercise this time around, but I'm damn proud of it. It works tremendously well, and I'm very proud of how Denon DJ did the Dropbox integration. It's so much better, and I must say that it's so much better as how Rekordbox 6 handles the cloud synchronization. This is the way to go. This is how it's supposed to work. Just put everything on Dropbox and no dedicated service, etc. Already we are through. You can see, let me make it a little bit bigger right here, that iTunes are there. Those are the two that I just did. But in this particular playlist, and if you make it, you see, are the tracks that were added by iTunes, but those are not analyzed yet. And if you want to use them, you better analyze them. So I just analyze them. And if they are analyzed, we can quit Denon Prime. We can wait for the Dropbox thingy to disappear. And that won't take long. And again, folks, don't forget to log out your Dropbox. And I think I just didn't do that. I think I'm still logged into Dropbox. Yay, I'm still logged into Dropbox on my other machine, which means this will most likely go wrong because I just ejected and disconnected from Dropbox. And this is exactly what I'm talking about. This is a kind of thing that can go wrong. So you need to know about that. Let's double check what is going on in Dropbox, because I can already see by the number of files whether or not we are overruled by the sync back from. That looks to be right. That looks to be right. Oh, I think we are good. But let me double check that by Denon Prime, which doesn't start up by its. Let me put it right there. Really? And let's get rid of both of them, because otherwise I keep clicking them like this. And let me double check if my iTunes playlists are still there. Yay, that all looks, yeah, looks like we are good. Yes, we want to quit. Again, having to wait until it is synchronized and hoping that it didn't delete anything. But if it did delete anything, then we at least know why it did that. Going to the player. Attaching the previously empty Prutz drive again, because now it has the cache from the previous session on it. You know, that stuff that I really don't like. Log into Dropbox. And we jump through all the hoops again. I know this is a little bit of a drag, but well, let's face it, usually you don't go back and forth between your computer and the player and your computer and the player. You basically only do that if you know that if you basically do it just once in the evening and not all the time. So right now it looks like a lot of work, but it basically comes down to doing it once and then be happy with it. Let me look which code I got this time around. Codepn. And pair the stuff up. And I love to do this kind of stuff in real time, folks, so you can see that indeed this is working, that this is not. Now let's see if it took the Dropbox here. There it is. And there you got the iTunes parts, the iTunes stuff I did put on it. and again it loads up, and that all works. And let's eject this, because otherwise we fall for the same trick once again. All right, now we got this Dropbox drive, and there is more that we can do with it than just using it for Denon Prime, because I can use this Dropbox drive with everything. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to TeamViewer into my other computer. And let me do that right here. I hope I got, no, it's not responding. I need to get the number of that computer and see that I can connect to it, because otherwise it won't respond. Don't you love technology? All right. This should do the trick, hopefully. Have to know everything about everything, don't you? Let's see. That doesn't seem to respond either. Why not? That's weird. Let me double check my team for your preferences here. I swear it worked before, but that really doesn't account for much. Ah, there we go. And as you can see, this is the Contour computer, as it is named. And Contour is office in Dutch. And there you see also the Dropbox thingy. Now let's take a close look, because this is the same Dropbox as we were looking at on the computer I am at right now. You can see all our stuff there, including the test folder. Everything is there. Now if you look inside the Rekordbox Track Backup Tool folder, you find the iTunes Music Library XML, the Rekordbox XML, and this is a sync XML, which you can use as well, but it's a Rekordbox it's a Rekordbox kind of XML, so only used by DQ. But we can use these files, we can access them, because these files point to the tracks on Dropbox. Now you have to keep in mind that tracks on Dropbox on one machine are not the same file path as tracks on Dropbox on another machine. So I automatically installed this little applet script, whatever you want to call it, which will correct the Dropbox file paths for the given computer they are on. So if I run it right there, you will see it creates an iTunes music library with Filmpjes account in brackets, because that's the name of the account of that machine. You see an iTunes music library with Dropbox drive between brackets. That is in case you use a Dropbox mountable drive, then you need that XML. A Rekordbox user, which can be used in Rekordbox, and a Rekordbox Dropbox drive, again, if you use a mountable drive image there. So it's a lot to take, but it's pretty much self-explanatory. There is also a great tutorial I made about XML files for DJs in under 6 minutes. I try to link it above my head right now, so I will do that after this stream. I will make sure that you can read that. Now let me show you what you can do with this stuff, because that's more important. First of all, if we go to, let's take Rekordbox 6, why not? Let's live dangerously. Let's go for Rekordbox 6. And if we go to the preferences of it, let me put it full screen so you can at least the quality is a little bit better like this. And I go to the advanced part, the database part, as you can see. And then I can say I want to use the iTunes XML. And let's make this a little bit bigger if I can. Why not? Right, then not. This is the iTunes Music Library Filmpjes account, which you want as the iTunes. And then we've got the Recordbox XML part, which contains our queue. And that means we have the Recordbox XML. No, not that one, because that's the Dropbox drive, as you can see right there. We need this one, Recordbox Filmpjes account. Open it up. And what did I just do? Let me show you that. I'm not sure if there is, or there is some cloud info there. All right, some leftovers. If we go to the Recordbox XML, you can see this is the stuff I just worked on. And I can load it up, and you've got your queue, your memory queue, and you've got your hot loop. Everything is there as you're supposed to have it. So that means if I'm at a friend's computer and we are preparing a back-to-back set, I can just temporarily use this. I can temporarily access this and just put it in. And the moment I sign off of Dropbox, I throw away the Dropbox account, everything is gone. So you can very easily have access from Dropbox. But things get even a little bit better than that. Let's fire up music. And of course I'm going to have a fight with, and let's, I hold the option key down. That means that it will bring up this dialogue, and then I can either choose or create a library. But let's choose a library, and let's point it on Dropbox to the iTunes. Let's see, it doesn't, I thought I could point it to the XML directly. Apparently not. Then create a library, that's fine. Let's call it music. Replace it, why not? Let's just empty this one then, because this is my demonstration machine after all. And then we go to, let me find it, because it has been a while that I did this, folks, so bear with me. Oh, it must be, that was the problem. It must be named iTunes Music Library. That will still work, but then we just take this one, put it inside music, like that. And then let's see if I can find it. There it is. This is not what I wanted to show you, but this will work, and that's why I want to show you. And then let's start up. Come on, like that. And now it should allow me to pick it. No, it still doesn't. All right, then let's see if we can import it straight away, and otherwise I just leave it for what it is. And we go to Traktor and show you how you can do it in Traktor, and you can do it with lots of other stuff. But that's a little bit of a problem with Catalina machines. Since the Apple framework has been introduced, things got a little bit messy, to say the least. Thank you, Apple, for that. You make my life so much easier. No, I don't have... Oh, here I want it to be. Library, import playlists. And let's see if it picks that up, and otherwise we leave it for what it is. No, it does it. You see that? That is still on our Dropbox. So if I just show in Finder, you will see right here that it's coming from the Dropbox account, the one I did on my Mojave machine. So you can even update that. And even more, if I go to Traktor, but I think you already got that part now. And you go to the preferences inside Traktor, the file management section. Enable the use legacy XML, because that's what we are going to use. We go not through the framework, but we go through the XML. Then find the iTunes, not this one, but this one for the Filmpjes account. You can see a little bit of it there, and otherwise I had to make it bigger, but this will work fine. And we close this up, and then right here we've got the tracks from our Dropbox account. And this track had tags from Tractor inside, so that's why you see cues appearing there, and most likely those are mixed in key cues by the likes. But yeah, you see the TCK queue, a mixed in key queue. So this kind of stuff is pretty powerful to use. Mainly the collection backup tool is the big enabler of this, and the Denon Conversion Utility is just made compatible with it. But the collection backup tool is which makes it all possible, that you can just drop it all on Dropbox and just pick it up any way you like it. And you get that with the Denon Conversion Utility. It's also a separate tool. So that is what I wanted to show you folks. Again, the Denon part of this is entirely beta. I already showed you some shortcomings and things that needs to be fixed. There are some more underneath, which I really cannot show because those are really technical things, and I don't think Denon want me to show you how you can hack their database, for instance. So let's not do that. I'm going back and see if I've got questions. So Dropbox crashes from a specific drive with Dropbox. No, Dropbox doesn't crash with a specific drive from Dropbox. The problem is that the Dropbox integration of the drives, so Prime for an SC5000 or whatever, still require a drive to be present. And I really don't want that. There is no need for it. I understand that there is a need for some caching, so you must cache some stuff. So that's okay to put it on the drive. But the moment I eject that drive, everything Dropbox should be gone, should be entirely gone, because I don't want residual files spread around. So that's one thing that Denon really should fix, and I think they will, because let's face it, with guys like Laidback Luke as your ambassador, you better want to be sure that you're not spreading residual files all around. I use my internal Denon drive inside my Denon Prime 4. That will work fine, Mike. Mac, you can. I did test this with my own Denon performance drives, and that's fine if you use the internal drive in your Prime 4. That's fine in SC5, but that's also that's your own gear, so you don't mind that there are tracks residual there. That really doesn't matter because it are your tracks. My fear is mainly for those artists and those producers who work festivals, who work clubs, who leave residual files without them knowing it or without them understanding it. You just saw me emptying my whole Prutz drive. You can do it from an empty drive. If you have an XFAT formatted USB, you're good to go. Plug it in, it can be empty. But then again, if you've got that empty USB drive, why don't you have your performance drive with you? So that takes away kind of the whole idea behind being able to do it from Dropbox, because it works, as I showed you, but it's not fast. An SSD will still be faster than Dropbox any time of the day, and that's understandable because it's networkable, but it's a very neat solution. It's a great solution. Any other questions, folks? Any other things that you might want to know about how this stuff works, what you can do with it? Because otherwise I'm coming to the end of this unexpected stream, let's face it. That also means that the beta period for the new DQ, the Denon Conversion Utility, and the new Collection Backup Tool is open. So if you have an official license for the Denon Conversion Utility, just hit me up on Facebook Messenger. Don't post a post about, hey, what is the download link, because I'm not doing that in the public area. Just put it in Messenger. And don't forget to give me the thumbs up, to share this video, to share that this is really possible and really working. And in general, help me with my social media outlets, because my social media exposure is still only a tiny fraction of my actual user base. And in order for companies like Denon DJ for taking me serious, I need to show some social media exposure, like it or not. That's the way that we work these days. All right, guys. Thank you so much for showing up and having your questions and joining me during this stream. I didn't expect very much people around because this was totally unexpected and fall out of thin air. But I'm happy that you did.